Long Notch is well stocked, as you asked.
Other runners to
and our scouts are...
But our purpose was to take back the mountain. Now what?
Stay prepared. Sharpen your spears. Should we not return, defending the cut falls to you. If our chieftain agrees with this course.
Sounds like good advice, but let's hope it doesn't come to that.
Chieftain?
The weight of command is no small burden.
I can see that. I take it you haven't spoken to Araya yet?
Why should I? This is what she wanted, to return to Thunder's Drum. It is her only care. So I should have known she would find a way to push aside my spear. After the Karja took my sister, not all of her came back.
What happened to Araya when she was a captive of the Karja?
As a shaman, she's adept with machines, tracking them, stunning them. The Karja used her to capture them for the Sunring, where they were unleashed upon the innocent. They made her part of their blood sport. The shame she suffered beneath their pitiless sun.
She survived.
She endured. Endured by reminding herself of the spirit, her purpose. But now that's all she has.
Tell me what happened to the first expedition.
Araya led the way to the summit, but it was blocked by a great door, some kind of cauldron, new metal. We tried to break through, but it was unflinching. We were exhausted, no way forward and machines behind. I made the call to push back. It cost us greatly, but to remain would have cost us everything. I had hoped to never subject Araya to that again.
What do you think is beyond that door?
I do not know. That expanse of metal, that dead hum. Nothing sacred belongs there. Machines and death, that's what the mountain holds. Death for us or for the daemon.
And if we do find the spirit?
Then perhaps we should put it out of its misery.
What do you think is beyond that?
I do machine.
And if.
Then perhaps.
For what it's worth, I'm glad you're coming with me.
Someone has to keep Araya safe.
For every hunt I accept. During every
I wish you luck on the mountain.
Aloy, this is it. My chance to reunite with the spirit and perhaps to reunite her with the blue light. It's not a chance I would have had alone. I needed an outsider. Someone ignorant of our ways, but no, not ignorant.
Are you trying to thank me, Araya?
Yes, of course. That's what you do. Untangle knots. Create possibilities. Thank you for making this pilgrimage possible. I only wish it had not been necessary to humiliate Aratak. You were wise to let him come. He's earned the right. Stubborn as stone, but he's had to be. The war demanded it. And so have I.
Aratak told me you were a captive of the Karja for a long time. It sounded bad.
For Aratak, it all comes back to that. He thinks the Karja changed me. They did not. They merely sharpened my focus. When all else is lost, you think about what's truly important. The spirit. The blue light. The beyond. And my brother, too. Every time I felt the chill northern wind, I thought of him, worried for him.
What did the war do to Aratak?
He cut away everything until only his true self remained. Unyielding ice. Nobunuk has more sheer will. He fought the Karja for 1,000 freezing nights, yet always rallied his hunters at sunrise. It is said he endured 23 wounds in those years. His hunters counted them. He never complains of one. Instead, he complains that life with me is harder. He's right. What have I ever given him but struggle?
What are we gonna find up there, Araya?
Ruins. Machines. And a door, like that of a cauldron. I have faith that you can find a way through it, Aloy. For beyond it lies the spirit. I know I can find her there. Though I do not doubt the daemon has tried to hide the way.
Now that I'm chieftain of the Werak, I don't suppose I can order you to tell me about Silence?
Aratak would never have presumed to grasp for a secret of the Conclave. But you are not Aratak, and if you have dealt with Silence, your need is well apparent. Silence came to Bon-Or from the distant north, a young shaman of the Owl's Watch, a remote Werak that rarely comes south to parley.
Silence was a shaman.
He was. Or at least, when we sent runners to ask the Owl's Watch, they said he was. His knowledge of the machines was beyond compare, and he was hungry to trade what he knew to the rest of us. It didn't take him long to gain the trust of the Conclave, and eventually, an invitation to attend.
What about you? Did you trust him?
No. But he impressed me. He carried himself with poise and authority. I wanted to learn from him, but that was not to be. He was granted knowledge of our most sacred meeting place, the frozen caves of the Malmstrom, a month's march from Bon-Or. He met with us there, as is custom at high winter. But when we next returned, the caves had been looted. Relics of the old world stolen, holes cut in ice and metal.
Yeah, that'd be Silence, all right.
He vanished with the spoils. We sent our best trackers after him. None returned. And when we checked back with the Owl's Watch, those who had vouched for him were gone, as though he never existed. Some in the Conclave began to doubt he was even Banuk to begin with.
And what do you think?
He committed an unforgivable sacrilege. He's unscrupulous and dangerous, but also brilliant, skilled, and knowledgeable without equal. Except, perhaps, for you. Anyone else I would warn off, but you may be able to treat with him safely. Just don't lower your guard.
I'll keep that in mind, Araya. Thanks. It hasn't been easy for you, Araya, getting back to this point.
It was all to hear her voice again. This time, we both will.
I'd like that.
Are you ready, then? Once we ascend, it will be hard to turn back. Finally, we ascend.
How? I don't see a way up.
Not up. Through.
Now, brother! You can call upon the power of the old ones. What was this place? The spirit once told me that this all used to be part of its domain. A fortress that defended humankind from a terrible danger.
Fortress? It looks more like a machine.
Is that not fitting? The blue light often dwells in machines.
Let's just hope that some remains here. Metal pillars. Tall as Bunyuri's cliffs. I still don't like it.
Once, these halls rang with the spirit's presence.
Here, up and over.
November 21st, 2064. It's been 3 years since I was last here, and 12 since I was running the place. Just a skeleton crew left, confused about why I'm here. So am I. Anita wants me to find a way to suspend operations for a while. Maybe a long while. And I don't know why. But from the sound of her voice, it was something terrifying. I wish I could look into her eyes, ask her what the hell she's so freaked out about, but... what else is new? When don't I wish I could look into her eyes again?
Aloy?
Were you listening?
There are... memories here. Messages. Left by the old ones.
And you can hear them. I envy you. What did they say?
I'm not sure yet, Araya. They're machines. At least we have the drop on them.
We must climb higher, and our path will become clear. We can make our way upwards when you're done.
Full already.
Is measured, ours is measured.
There's an overlook above. It's not far.
Thank you.
It's not freezing, please.
To ditch something.
Not much farther now.
Last we were here, we fought our way through there. The machines overcame us. We retreated, dropping supplies and taking losses. Now we must prevail, with only two warriors and a shaman to protect.
Aloy is no ordinary warrior. And I can hold my own. Even so, we could go that way instead. There are machines up there, but also cover. We could stay hidden, at least for a while.
All right, I get the options. Now follow my lead. Oops. Towers. Steam. Frost.
Thank you.
endured worse pain.
Bodies of our kin remain to shame us for our last attempt.
Their spirits are one with the blue light now, Artok.
We may soon join them. Take whatever supplies are left to keep us alive a bit longer.
Their efforts hard enough.
Soon enough.
These towers pulse with heat, like an awesome forge.
With vibrations underfoot. Are they tapping into something underground?
More machines.
Thank you.
geothermal pipeline is the easy part. Making sure it can come back online without degradation is harder. It would help if Anita had told me how long it needs to be out. Years. Decades. What will that do to the Count?
They saw me. This is it.
Look out! More machines! Was open the last time.
But Damon has closed it to us.
Then we'll find another way.
Aratok's right. Let's get to the tower. Harden our hearts, steady our aim. I went this way years ago, looking for cover in case machines came prowling. I have no doubt that it is guarded now, but we may be able to stay hidden. Down as we move through. Thank you.
That's cold. As if there's chill water running through those massive pipes. But why? I can't spare the weight.
Trip to mine.
Got too much
Brace
already.
Yourself.
Quickly. feel my... I can't feel much of anything in this. Now, Rome.
Technically, I can't suspend the cooling system, but I can reduce the power draw so that it'll be completely masked by the caldera. But masked from what? Firebreak has always been confidential for security reasons, but this would be excessive, even for the dear departed Mr. Blevins. What could possibly have gotten Anita so worked up?
Should have brought a cart. This projector? Maybe to show holograms without a focus. Let's see if I can restore power. Aratak, Araya, you might see shapes drawn from light. Don't be alarmed.
It'll take more than light to alarm me. I do not like it here, looking out over where my kin fell.
Thank you for being here, everyone. I suppose it's not every day you get to have cocktails inside an active volcano, right? Unless you're George, and I can hardly blame him for drinking on the job. None of this would be here without our beloved director, Kenny Chow. So, here's to you, Kenny. You put a cork in the Yellowstone caldera. I'd say you deserve a margarita.
We're looking glasses, everyone. I'd like to add something. This effort wouldn't have been possible without our lead programmer. Thank you, Anita, for bringing us our real mastermind, Cyan.
I'll second that, Director Chow. All right, Cyan, what's our latest number?
The current count is 1,654.
Well, then drink up, everyone. Here's to 1,654 more years without an eruption.
It was the spirit, the old ones. I could only grasp some of what they said.
You were right, Araya. This place was built to stop something terrible. And it worked. As for the spirit, I'm starting to get an idea of what it could be.
The door is open now. We can get through. There. Below. Door to the mountain. New metal.
Dead metal. We could not pass it before.
We will this time. We have to.
We'll have to carve through a lot of machines to get to that door.
More than the Werak could prevail against before.
Aloy will see us through.
Onward, then. Our challenge awaits.
The geothermal plant can be suspended. The cooling system masked. Massive challenges solved. So why am I so nervous about the next part? All we need to do is install Anita's mysterious software and have a conversation. It's not even a human being, right?
We should move on. Onto the mountain.
Introduced. Forget about traveling light. I'd have to ditch something. Forget about traveling light.
More machines. Make ready. More machines. Make ready.
Ah!
songs of deeds, but that battle was a verse worth singing.
Now, Aloy, the door. Can you open it?
Let's find out.
Please, Aloy. Open the door.
Years have passed since I stood here. Since then, the daemon has taken over.
It's like an infection, attacking all this machinery.
Everything has changed. It's twisted. The path I took to get to the spirits, lost to us.
Find a new path, Araya. I promise. All right. Let's go.
Yes. And finish this.